remember guys like Dylan Everett and Alan Green so far are practicing.
Those guys are just hungry. those guys are just hungry. They want to get better every day. You know, they want to learn from their mistakes. You know, they just want to do anything to make the team better, really.
I guess what is your role feel like for you this spring is, and now that Keeley's gone, you're kind of the incumbent starter there at point.
I say my role this year, I'm trying to become a better leader, you know, more of a vocal guy, you know, lead by example and try to bring. We got a lot of mid-years of young guys and just trying to help bring some of those guys along.
Is it hard to fill those shoes? I mean, Keeley was that guy. He was coming off the pick six last year. Is it hard to kind of take over that role?
Keeley, you know, Keeley was a great player, a great guy, one of my good friends. But, you know, I really learned a lot from him and guys like him, DK, and Speed. You know, they taught me the way. So I wouldn't say it's so hard because I know the formula. I know what to do and how to do it.
From a leadership standpoint, what were some of the things you learned from those guys?
You know, just trying to approach every day like it's your last day, like it's your last opportunity. You know, treating the G with respect, doing the little things right, sweeping the sheds, and off the floor.
Javon mentioned the other day when we talked to him how that you and he and Taki were talking about how crazy it is that all of a sudden you guys are the older guys in that room. You know, what is that like? Kind of look around, being like, all right, you know, we are some more experienced guys.
When you really think about it, it's kind of crazy because it just feels like. Yesterday I was just coming in. I was a new guy on the block, you know, just learning. Now I'm going into my third year, and we got some younger guys that are looking up to us, you know, to lead the way. It's kind of crazy.
You said it. Javon said it. Kirby said it. Eating off the floor. What exactly does that mean to you, and what kind of actions does that look like?
Eating off the floor is just a mentality. Like you're not too big for anything. You're not too big to do the little things right. You're not too big to do the things that got you to where you are. So I mean, eating off the floor is just. Going in and approaching every day, like I said, like it's your last day, you know, giving your best at every opportunity you have.
What's the motivation? And I know that Coach Smart is a master motivator, and last year he had a lot of you guys sold on apparently nobody thought you were going to be good or something, he said, which couldn't be further from the truth, by the way. But now everybody thinks you're going to be good. You're going to be a preseason number one to make history as a three-peat. So, where do you feel like the team has drawn some inspiration here? Or is there still a chip on the shoulder? Or, like, what do you think collectively the team is motivated by this offseason?
I think we're motivated by just, you know, not getting complacent, not trying to stay stagnant. You know, if we stay stagnant, then people will catch up to us. And then if people catch up to you, you're eventually going to get beat. And just not wanting to lose, you know, at Georgia, we want to win every game. We want to win against everybody we play. So, I mean, just the will to win is what's keeping us going.
Obviously, you knew that there was an opportunity to win championships here, but if somebody would have told you, now you played your high school ball in the Tuscaloosa area, right? If somebody would have said, hey, Georgia's got a chance to three-peat, I mean, would you have been all in on that, or would you have said, well, there's some work to do with what Alabama's done?
Back then, there's no telling what I would have said. I'd be like, wherever the rain's at, that's where I'm going.
When you look at the defense, the fact you guys have to replace a lot of guys like Keeley, you know, guys who were big contributors, what's the key for the guys that are coming back to try to make the most of the spring and help everybody get up to speed?
Really just leading by example. Really just, you know, approaching every day the same way, with the same motivation, with the same tenacity that you did your first day, you know, whenever you were trying to get a starting spot, and just trying to bring the young guys along, you know. Everybody's gonna make mistakes, but it's how you learn from those mistakes and don't make the same mistake twice.
What have you seen from AJ Harris as he's gotten adjusted and going into second week spring?
He's a young guy, but he's very hungry. I mean, he wants to learn. He wants to be the best that he can be. He's just very tenacious. I mean, he comes in for extra film. He watches extra tape. He does extra work after practice, and you know, he listens as well.
How big was Chris to y'all's success? What's going to be the biggest challenge in replacing him?
Chris is one of those guys that you can't really, you know, describe on paper because he did so much for our team. You know, on the field, you know, he was a playmaker and a leader. And off the field, you know, he was a guy that you could talk to about things outside of football, you know, because he was an older guy. You know, he'd been through a lot of stuff that, you know, a lot of younger guys hadn't been through. And he was a guy that, you know, you could always, you know, lean on to be there, you know, both on the field and off the field. And trying to replace a guy like that, I mean, it's definitely going to be hard, but you know, we got the guys, you know, in our room and on our team that, you know, have learned from him, and, you know, we have the formula, so it's just a matter of just trying to do that.
Who are those guys that you think you know might step in at that spot?
You know, we just got a lot of guys rotating right now. You know, a lot of guys just leading in the DB room as a whole. Myself, Taki, Bullard trying to lead. You know, we got Nile and Dalen coming along trying to lead. And just a lot of guys, you know, just buying into the process.
What have been your impressions of Smoke Bowie so far and what he's been able to bring in coming in from Texas A&M?
Smoke is also one of those guys that's just hungry, you know. Coming in from a different school, you know, it's kind of tough, you know, coming into a different environment because you don't really know anybody. But, you know, he's gelled pretty well with us, and, you know, he's one of those guys that he just wants to get better every day.
And I don't know how much 11-on-11 or good on good you guys have done against the quarterback so far, but what have been your impressions of Carson, Brock, Gunner, the Springs? They're trying to replace Stetson.
All three of those guys are just very talented, you know, can make every throw, can give defenses issues, you know, both with their arms and their legs, and just very smart guys and guys who know how to run offense.
What have you learned working with Coach Brown over the last year, and how much more comfortable are you knowing sort of what his expectations are?
Coach Brown, he taught me a lot, man. You know, coming in last year, you know, I had two DB coaches already, and he was probably my third, and, you know, it was, you know, kind of like, oh, here we go again. But, you know, he's come in and he's, you know, treated me and the rest of my guys like family. You know, he really cares about us. He loves us, and he's willing to go the extra mile, whether it's in the film room, getting up early every day to, you know, help us with our technique, watching film, or just getting extra work after practice. And, you know, we had a year together, so I really know, like, you know, what he expects from us. And he knows, like, you know, how to get me to go, you know, whenever everyone has those days. You know, he knows what to say to get me going. And he knows how to, you know, lead a room.
And along those same lines, you got all these different players, different personalities. How hard is it for a coach like Coach Fran to really get to know them like that and understand, like you said, what makes everybody tick?
You know, just trying to get to know everybody on a personal level outside of football. You know, that's what it really takes, you know. Just trying to, you know, get connected with your players and with your teammates. You know, you can't really just be connected on the field because, I mean, like, you got to go. You got to do stuff outside. You got to get to know guys wise, and you got to really talk to people.
Didn't you and Keeley just play left and right last year? Did you guys switch based on boundary and field?
We just played left and right. We didn't do field and boundary.
The reason I ask, I just wondered, with Keeley gone, is there any benefit reason for you to move to the other side, or do you work at both sides, or is,
yes,
you know,
sir. We all the corners we work at both sides. It's not really one guy that's just set on one side. You know,
I'm sure you've covered him at some point in practice. What makes Brock Bowers so good?
Brock is just one of those guys that, man, he's probably one of those guys that whenever you think of eating off the floor, he's probably one of the people that's on the top of the list. I mean, he came in, worked hard, you know, All-American his freshman year, but his sophomore year, he did the same thing every day, you know, came in, worked hard, ran hard, team runs, you know. He's not big of a vocal guy, but you can see, like, whenever you watch him, he's leading by example. I think that's what just makes him, you know, such a great player, that he's just willing to do things that it takes to be great.
For a defensive back room that's replacing Chris and replacing Keeley, how big were those, like, team runs and workouts and stuff over the past couple months in terms of figuring out leaders and developing chemistry with a new group of guys?
I say that was pretty huge because you get to learn the most about people, you know, whenever all y'all are tired, you know, whenever all you are, you know, suffering together, you know, running hard, and, you know, guys get to, you know, gel at those times, you know, whenever things go wrong, you know, that's whenever you want to be connected the most. So just those team runs in general, they really help.
Is there one particular day or moment where you really started to feel like that secondary group is starting to come together?
You know, really, with the guys in the room, like, we've been kind of, you know, together. We played all last year, and it was only, you know, a couple of new guys, you know, but, you know, they just bought in, like, the new majors, they bought in, the guys that, you know, just came in to already what was already set in stone. So it wasn't really much of a, you know, trying to get everybody to buy in. You know, those guys are willing to do it.
You said thoughts on Ra-Ra and love it so far. I mean, you played against them last year. What's it like teammates, and how would you say those guys are doing so far?
Well, I mean, I'm glad that they're my teammates now. I mean, those guys are really good players, you know. Gardner last year, you know, had to watch a lot of film on both those guys, you know, just to, you know, make sure I was on my A game. But, you know, bringing them to Georgia, you know, it just increases the intensity of practice, you know, the competition level between the receivers and the DBs. And that's some things, like, guys like me, you know, ultra competitive guys, like, I like that, you know. I want the best guys of the year, you know, and they want to go against the best guys as well. So, you know, just those guys being here, it's really good for us.
Did they have the physicality yet? Because I know that Kirby's huge on these receivers blocking, and that means battling guys like you even in practice. Have they shown that, or do you think they're still adjusting to the Georgia physicality?
I think those guys have shown it. I mean, I think that they're bought into, you know, the Georgia way and the way we do things around here. You know, I mean, obviously, like, you know, when you first get here in your first couple practices, things are a little different because we do things differently here. But I say that those guys have bought in and that, you know, they're just going to keep buying in.
You said one of your goals for the spring is to be a better leader. What does that effort look like on a daily basis to be a better leader?
You know, just trying to lead from, you know, the start of the day to the end of the day. Trying to bring guys in with me for extra film in the mornings. You know, I'm trying to bring guys with me for extra film after practice. You know, after practice, we work on technique a lot in the DB group, you know, just working on certain things and just trying to be a vocal guy. You know, sometimes, you know, the younger guys are going to mess up because, you know, you're not really familiar with the playbook yet. And, you know, just trying to help those guys, you know, learn and doing the walkthroughs, trying to show them, you know, that the walkthroughs are important and stuff like that. You know, just trying to work your technique and, you know, just trying to be a good leader.
Saw you and a couple other players were at the NASCAR race on Sunday. What'd you think?
That was my first time going. It was pretty cool. Scars was loud.
Got time for two more.
Did you have to wear headphones, or were you just kind of using your ears?
I was just using my ears. I didn't wear headphones.
What do you think you've grown the most, whether it be mentally or physically or anything like that, from where you were last year competing for a starting job to now being looked at as the guy in the cornerback position for this team?
I think where I've grown the most is you know, just mentally, you know, coming in mentally prepared for every day. You know, I know what it takes to be a Georgia Bulldog. I know what it takes to be a DB here. I mean, it's not easy. If it was easy, everybody would do it. So I mean, just trying to keep my mental correct, because you know, you could be physically strong but have a weak mind, and you know, things would go bad. So just trying to keep, you know, just trying to be mentally tough, you know, through all situations.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.